What is meant by recycling? Recycling is the process of turning trash into new products or materials out of the thrown out products which are considered to be worthless or useless anymore. It is an alternate method of disposing of waste to the traditional method that helps in conserving the utilization of fresh resources and making the reuse at its best to produce a new product. It helps in reducing the emission of greenhouse gases when these wastes are burnt in open land areas. Recycling is an effective way to reduce the waste because it prevents the need to create new products from the beginning, which requires a lot of energy and loss of resources. Destroying the natural resources to create new products further generates a lot of waste, and the new waste will be added to the existing waste, and this unorganized way of handling waste keeps moving on. It will lead to a lack of resources for the future generation. It also reduces the amount of waste that end up in landfills. Other methods of waste reduction includes composting, which is a process of breaking down organic waste into fertilizers, and waste-to-energy programs, which convert waste into electricity or fuel. What are the benefits of recycling? Number 1. It helps to save energy. Recycling process of materials requires only less energy for creating a new product than producing a fresh product from its beginning stage. As producing new products requires a lot of energy, and for such new production, a huge amount of natural resources will be destroyed. In order to reduce the excessive destruction of resources, recycling is the only solution for reducing the generation of new waste and producing new products from the existing waste that are meant to be obsolete and thrown out. This is because recycling relies on reusing materials that have already been through the process of extraction, production, and delivery rather than starting from the beginning. For example, in case of recycling aluminium cans, recycling saves 95% of energy that would be required to create a new aluminium can from the origin. Number 2. Conserves resources. Resources can be conserved using the techniques of recycling and composting. Recycling conserved resources for producing new products instead of disposing or discarding waste into the soil. Recycling also reduces the need to extract new raw materials from the earth, which can save energy and help to protect the environment. Number 3. Reduces the pollution. Recycling helps to reduce the pollution because it helps to reduce the amount of waste that are produced. When people recycle, they are able to reuse the materials that would otherwise been thrown away. This reduces the amount of waste that is produced and helps to keep the environment clean. Recycling helps to reduce the pollution by reusing material instead of creating new products from the beginning. This process requires less energy and generates less pollution than making products from the beginning. Recycling starts by sorting materials into different categories. The most common recyclable commodities are paper, glass, metal, and plastics. Once these materials are sorted, they will be sent for cleaning, and finally, these recyclable products are processed into new products. How are wastes recycled? Recycling of paper waste. All the paper waste are collected from various sources that are newspapers, magazines, print papers, etc. The papers will be separated and segregated according to their type, and this action helps to recycle more efficiently. Then the paper is sent to the recycling center, and then it will be sent to the paper mills. Paper is recycled by breaking it down into small pieces and adding water. These small pieces are then mixed with chemicals and turned into a pulp. The pulp is then placed on the screen and pressed to remove the water. Then the pulp is dried and turned into new products such as toilet papers, paper towels, and other items. Recycling of glass waste. Most glass waste is recycled into new glass products. The recycling process begins by sorting the glass by color. Next, the glass is cleaned and crushed into small pieces called the cullet. The cullet is then melted and formed into new glass products. Recycling of metal waste. There are a few ways to recycle metal waste. One way is to simply recycle the metal waste into new products. This can be done either melting down the metal waste and using it to create new products, or by shredding the metal waste and using it as a raw material in the production of new products. Another way to recycle metal waste is to use it as a fuel source. This can be done either by burning the metal waste to create heat or electricity or by using the metal waste as a raw material in the production of synthetic fuels. Finally, metal waste can also be recycled into other materials that can be used in a variety of applications. For example, metal waste can be used as a raw material in the production of concrete or asphalt. Recycling of plastic waste. The recycling process of plastic waste begins by sorting the various types of plastic by their resin content. The most common types of plastic are PET, polyethylene terephthalate, and HDPE, high density polyethylene, which are typically used for water and milk bottles. Once the plastic is sorted, it is chopped into small pieces and then melted. The molten plastic is then poured into a mold, which gives the desired shape. Once the plastic is cooled and hardened, it can be reused again. Recycling hierarchy. The recycling hierarchy is a framework for prioritizing waste management strategies. The goal of recycling hierarchy is to minimize waste and the negative environment impacts of waste management activities. The recycling hierarchy ranks waste management strategies from the most to the least preferred. The most preferred waste management strategy is source reduction, which is the practice of reducing the amount of waste that is generated in the first place. The next most preferred strategy is recycling, which is the process of collecting and reprocessing waste materials for use as a new product. The least preferred strategy is disposal, which is the process of discarding the waste materials in landfill or incinerator. The recycling hierarchy is often represented as a pyramid, with the source reduction at the top, followed by recycling and then the disposal. What are the 3 R's of waste management techniques? Number 1. Reduce. The first important step to reduce the level of waste generation is to reduce the waste at its source by way of choosing the required products for our consumption. As if we make wrong decisions, it will automatically lead to generation of waste. This includes everything from buying products with less packaging to bringing your own reusable bags to the store. Number 2. Reuse. The second important step to reduce the level of waste is reuse. Creating a new product from the things that we dispose of is possible if we plan to reuse that particular product. For example, you can use an empty yogurt container as a plant pot or turn an old t-shirt into a dust cloth. Number 3. Once you have reduced and reused as much as you can, recycling plays the final role in waste management. Because recycling involves the process of converting waste and discarded materials into new materials instead of producing from the beginning. Thanks for watching the video. As we have seen, what is meant by recycling, its benefits, recycling process of waste, recycling hierarchy, and the 3 R's of waste management techniques. For more updates, stay tuned to our CercleX YouTube page. Thank you.